Island, and Bits of SL Photography. So, who do you voodoo? But you can also visit their in-world location here, and what you can also follow them on Twitter here.
We also like to thank Ring of Fire Productions. Match photography is provided by Ring of Fire Productions. Whether it's virtual wrestling, nights at the club, glamour photo shoots, or capturing the beauty of the grid, Ring of Fire Productions aims to provide high-quality photographs at unbelievable rates. For all the latest photos from tonight's matches and around the grid, follow the Twitter account at ROF Productions. And we'd also love to thank Sashi Cat Productions. Looking for some professional Second Life video capturing and editing work for your organization's upcoming event? Consider Sashi Cat Productions. Reach out to our very own Sashi with ideas for current rates. You can find Sashi here during the show nights as she also live streams our shows. And you can watch current and past live streams, which generally include pre-show and after-show footage on her YouTube page. Linked in local.
Well, it is always awesome to have her and also, Ring of Fire Productions. They are both awesome.
Once again, looking at the show notes, we got an action-packed next show for you tonight. First up, looks like the Tomahawk taking on a mystery opponent.
Talk about mystery Pokemon. And it also looks like we have Emery and Javier.
That is absolutely going to be interesting. That might be... And those are our two resident dance partiers, so this could be quite the dance off as well as a wrestling match. Who knows?
I mean, who's gonna outdance who? That's the biggest question.
And then next up, Revel is in action tonight. She's been definitely making some headway in seemingly trying to get back into Strike Hero's head.
And she's very good at that. She is very good at that. And then after that match, it looks like we have Miss Rainbow versus a mystery opponent.
Yeah. Yeah, who knows what kind of surprises the Alicorn will have to brave. We'll have to brave on that one.
I mean, it's another mystery Pokemon. I just keep on waiting, for a actual Pokemon to come out.
You never know. Could happen.
It definitely could.
Next up, yep, Sora Kusanagi taking on Riv.
Ooh.
Now be a definitely true test for Sora.
It definitely will. Though I have watched just about every Jurassic Park movie, and you know, Velociraptors tend to beat, you know, out whatever, you know, they're up against. But hey. And then our final match is our main event match. Again, let's see, we got Calvin Hay. So going up against the what's the better way to put it that, you know, that's not mean? Hard-headed goat.
Happens to be the champion.
Yeah.
World heavyweight champion, Rick Bloodrose.
I mean,
this will be a tremendous opportunity for the Big Cheese.
It definitely will be. Or would be. And that's all I have on my cops card.
Yep, only proven that this is going to be an action-packed show.
Yes, and is everybody ready?
Yeah, exactly. How excited is everybody? We are only a few moments away. I think you guys can get louder than that.
Come on.
Ladies, gentlemen, all in between, let's hear it.
Oh, there we go. We asked the crowd, and the crowd has delivered.
I know. What show number is this?
I don't know.
It's like a number between 68 and 70.
The mean?
Right.
Wow. But you know what? I'm just going to call it Applebee's. That's what I'm going to do. And we're counting down, got a minute remaining until we begin. Is everybody ready? Do 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 do, just waiting. And here we go.
Showtime. Valiant Army, welcome to Valiant Flashpoint Super Show 69. Woo!
I'm ready.
I'd say it's just about ready to get down to the action.
I know. We're just waiting. This is definitely going to be an interesting night, and here we go. Alrighty.
It's our first
competitor. Alright. Our first wrestler tonight coming to us from Cleveland, Ohio at a height of 5'8" and weighing in at 175 pounds, it is the Tomahawk. And that over there with them.
I do believe that is Charlie Cofe.
Oh,
yeah, that's Charlie Covfefe.
Yes, it is.
Like whatever it was that happened last week with the okay, squashed it.
Yeah, definitely does.
Oh, I gotta take this one.
Let go right on ahead.
He is way to the ring from West Hollywood, California, standing at a height of 5'8", weighing 185 pounds. WrestleMania Square sweetheart, Dylan Patel.
And he has finally made it back.
Showering Dylan with welcome back.
Yes.
His CEO business had to put him away from the ring action, but he is back in this ring tonight, and you know he couldn't miss out on this particular super show.
Ain't that the truth?
High five. It looks like Tomahawk is just as happy as we all are to see Dylan back.
I know. Like, high five.
Both wrestlers are clean, check for ready, they give the signal, so let's get down to it.
Let's get it.
Tomahawk locking up, going for a wrist lock, but Dylan already carling and kicking his way out of it. Going to a wrist lock of his own, but Tomahawk able to flip and kick his way out of that one.
Ooh.
Oh, tries to go on off the ropes.
Oh, wow.
It's a wrist lock from Dylan.
Oh.
But only enough for a one.
Yeah.
Tomahawk off the ropes. Dylan off the ropes as well. Going under a clothesline. Doing.
I mean, they're and just bouncing all over.
An elbow.
Oh, that poor pupper.
Cecilia gets back up. Tomahawk charges in and another elbow. Stomping and clapping. That's definitely... You can never expect anything from Tomahawk sometimes. And whoa!
Whoa!
Clothesline sends Dylan out of the ring right to to the ring ramp.
Nope.
It's like Tomahawk's lining up his shot, but wait. And Patel just kicking him in the face. Now going off the ropes and diving axe handle.
Oh, owie, that's definitely gonna hurt.
Patel once again off the ropes. Going in for a senton. Another. Do I hear a third? Nope.
Nope. Oh.
The way out of the ring, but oh! Going off the ropes to vault on him for another senton. So there was that.
Ooh.
Now going for the cover. Only good for two.
Oh. I mean, they're definitely not
wasting. Absolutely back. Showing that there is no ring rust at all. But whoa!
Oh!
Quick thinking by Tomahawk, lifting, like, taking the ropes away, and now sending Dylan out of the ring. Like, Tomahawk's got ideas.
Oh, boy.
Time to turnbuckles.
It's time for a high-risk maneuver. Oop.
But Dylan slips back into the ring. Going for a somewhat, no! Whoa!
Oh.
How did Dylan manage to get a smash fly off of that?
I don't even know, but that was only good for like just a two count.
Again, that just shows the resilience of Tomahawk.
I mean, they're just going at it and then popping back up.
Going for a jump and clothesline, but oh! Gets a knee to the face for his troubles.
Ooh. Oh. Oh.
It's going to be a chance for Tomahawk. Nope.
What was that?
Leap over him, trying to get him confused, it looks like. And jumping onto Dylan's back. Just wailing on him, punch after punch. Dylan able to fight it off. But Tomahawk going off the ropes, coast to coast, and kneeing
Dylan
right in the face and putting him into a triple roll.
Oh.
Setting Dylan up. And whoa!
Ooh.
Manages to go coast to coast for that backstabber.
That hurt.
That cannot be good. Right. You definitely need your back to do all the athletic moves that Dylan's capable of doing. That can definitely put a dent on that game plan.
And that be
popping up for a Euro upper. Going in for a cover and only good for two.
Whew. I don't know how much more. I don't know how much more he can handle.
His coaching, but I'm pretty sure Tomahawk is handling himself just fine. Grabbing a hold of Dylan's foot now. Oh, and just when you think you had him, Dylan, with a wheelbarrow face buster.
Ooh.
Doing on the pickup. Sending a few kicks. Now sending Tomahawk off the ropes. And back to the corner. Cartwheeling and the Sylvania swing shot.
Nice. Episode
3. Now charging in and oh, the glitter facial. And oh, cannonball sent on.
Oh.
Pretty sure Tomahawk not a fan of that.
Probably not. Because I know I wouldn't.
Charlie trying to get him back going, but it's the power bottom. This could be it.
This?
1, 2, 3. Valiant Army, here's your match winner by pinfall, Dylan Mattel.
Woo! I mean, that's one of those matches that you don't even want to, like, win, and once you miss it.
Absolutely. Probably checking on Tomahawk to see if he's alright. You can see the frustration on Tomahawk there.
Yes, but you definitely can.
Looks like Charlie going over to congratulate Dylan and welcome him back. Wait a minute.
Oh!
What?
That,
Tomahawk just crashes into both Dylan and Charlie with a very unorthodox maneuver there.
It definitely is. Makes me wonder what's going through his head.
I remember there was. Remember that Tomahawk and Charlie weren't exactly seeing eye to eye at the end of their tag team match, but
they definitely weren't.
I thought it was good as squash. If they were still coming out, and wait a minute. That was gotten action brought to the table right now.
Ooh.
Wait a minute. Wait. No.
Tomahawk.
Backbreaker. You're onto. You're still on top of that table. That table still somehow hasn't broken yet.
Oh, Henry, no. Henry.
What do you mean? What does he mean? He can't be sick of Charlie. What?
I mean, they both just got came back.
And, oh, no!
Oh, the table breaks.
And Charlie. Laid out in half over that table now. Tomahawk, what? What is going in the tomahawk?
There is no telling. But that definitely is a bold move.
Even bolder, considering that Dylan is
right there.
Dylan is one of our CEO. One of our CEOs of Valiant, so high five. So he can definitely put some additional punishment onto Tomahawk here.
Yeah, he definitely can.
Dylan checking on Charlie.
Oh.
Charlie's slowly making his way up. I'm surprised he's even able to do that.
I am too.
Completely under his own power. Once again, showing the resilience that the Covfefes are capable of. Well, that certainly happened.
I mean, that's going to be the gossip. That's going to be gossiped about.
Oh, man. I just hope they're... maybe this time it'll be the end of whatever tension between Tomahawk and Charlie is.
I mean, we can only hope, but I'm kind of doubtful.
Right, considering he said, especially since he said he was sick of Charlie.
Mm-hmm.
About to keep tuning in to finding out what comes up of that.
We definitely will. Ooh, and it looks like we're moving on to the next one. And coming out now from Atlantic City, New Jersey, at a height of 5'9", and weighing in at 191 pounds, it's everybody's favorite ADHD spirit animal, Javier Azul. He is one of my top three favorites.
Oh, absolutely. Also, the head of both Helios and Remy Appreciation Societies.
Yeah.
Might be one of the few times where he and his opponent might actually have something in common. Speaking of standing at a height of 5'3", weighing in at 140 pounds from the closest rave party,
and I cannot store,
here comes Emery.
I'm ready to deny, can't tame your soul.
And it looks
tonight,
like Loving tonight, and Chicago accompanying him.
That's gonna make for things interesting.
I do remember Chicago taking an interest in coaching up Emery.
Mm-hmm.
Well, both of our wrestlers are checked.
Yep.
Both clean and given the check for ready. Everybody's saying, let's dance. And telling Javier to dance is... he might actually do it.
He just might.
Emery going in for a clothesline, but wait a minute.
Give me my title.
Get off me, you little shit. I'm not even in the match. Get off me.
Well, then.
Hey, did you forget for the matches against? You shouldn't have.
Well, the emotions are still running high for Javier.
And yeah.
He still has his sights set on trying to get that championship back from Shango.
Definitely is. I mean, he made it clear, you know, the last time he was out about that.
Unfortunately for Javi, he has Emery to worry about.
Yes, Javi. Need you to focus on Emery.
And Emery lining up his shot right now. Javi rolling up. Emery off the ropes, and knee strike. Oh. Got some hang time off of that move, too.
Yeah, definitely did.
Javier going in for the cover. Probably wants to make this quick so he can just put all of his focus right back to Shango. That's only good for a one. And I do not blame Javier one bit.
I don't either.
So, Emery, you don't need the Shango Man for the title. Let's do dance off. To fight.
Sure, I guess.
Yay!
And then looks like we're gonna have a dance off, folks.
I had a feeling this was gonna happen, and it is happening. Only in Valiant Wrestling do you get entertainment like this.
Exactly.
Uh-oh.
Cut that out right now.
Well,
fight him.
Well, then.
Whoa!
Oh!
I guess message received to Emery there.
I guess so.
Absolutely jumping Javi and going in for the cover. Only good for a two, though. Did not think Emery had that kind of game plan. Yet here we are, and there's a leg drop going off the ropes.
Ow.
He drop.
It's like up and drop and down.
And headbutt drop. Going up for the fourth time. Elbow drop. He's using every part of his body right now.
He definitely is.
Now going upstairs. Raven out with the 450 splash. The cover 1-2. But Javi kicks out.
And it's only a two count. That's been going around lately. 1-2. Let's just get a three.
He's a former Men's Pride champion, so he definitely has resilience. This would A win like this would definitely bring Emery right up the ranks.
It definitely would.
Oh! Emery sending Javi off the ropes, but Javi able to snap out of it and get that Enziguri. Now going off the ropes for a leg drop. Good chance for the Appreciation Society, the member, to take the momentum all the way back. Now going into that headlock. Emery's got to be careful to not make that a pin, and he's fighting his way out of it. Still in that headlock, though. He's breaking it up and sending Emery to the corner. Looks like he's about to go coast to coast. Closing the distance and going in with punch after punch.
Yes, yes. More punchy punch. That's what I like.
Backing off so there won't be a count. Now going in for a stinger splash. No shots to the middle. Now some athleticism of Javier's own. Cartwheel and somersaulting for that elbow. That hit him square in the, and that hit Emery square in the midsection. He is holding that tight, but Meteor, this is number one, two, no!
No!
And you can just see the confliction going through on Javier's face, because he knows he has to get through Emery if he wants to immediately try, if he wants to even try to jump Shango now.
Yeah.
Oh!
Oh! Howdy. That.
A crossbody off the ropes.
That looked painful.
For Emery there. Just like that momentum. Grinding to a halt. Oh, heading back upstairs. What's a Raven Rack going up? Going up to now. I'll be back on his feet. And wow!
Oh.
Diving out of the way before Javier can try to get him off the turnbuckle. And whoa! Black magic! Just when Javi thought he dodged that kick. Just an amazing display of athleticism.
It is.
Pay attention to what you're doing.
Like he's trying. Wow, it looks like he's actually taking Shango's advice.
Yes.
Doesn't look too happy about it, though. He took a little too long.
Yeah.
Because he was going in for that knee strike, but unfortunately was caught. Javier sweeping the leg.
That's gotta hurt.
A toe kick from Javi now. He's got Emery set up and scissors kick. Looks like he's lining up his shot. Going upstairs. This could be trouble. And it is scooter time!
It's always.
Wait a minute. What Mucky what? Somehow getting the attention of the referee.
Oh no, that typically means that's a bit trouble.
Right, Javi going upstairs. Oh, wait a minute. Oh no, shot. No. Don't think I didn't see that.
I think Mama's gonna be coming after him.
It doesn't matter if I didn't see it, if the ref didn't.
Yeah.
This could be a big opportunity for Emery here.
Oh!
And oh! Front flipping into that stunner. Going in for the cover. One, two, three.
Oh.
And here is your match winner by pinfall, Emery.
Aww.
Dance for the people.
I believe that's all of us. Shango, what you doing? Oh. And it looks like Emery didn't want him to do that.
That's not a fair way
to go to the back.
Well. Well, that happened.
Okay.
Don't you okay, Hobby?
Javi.
Yeah, that was.
And probably. And he is absolutely showing that there is no love lost between he and Shango right now.
Definitely not.
Especially as far as that Meds Pride Championship is concerned. But man, what an amazing set of action, and we still got a whole lot more tonight. Please continue to make some noise, crowd.
And we definitely have a lot more, but first, I just want to let everybody know that there is an after party at Oasis Lounge after all of this and the meet and greet.
Absolutely. Club Oasis always has very happening parties, especially when we get involved in the after party.
Exactly. And we're just waiting for, the next match. How's everybody doing? Is everybody having a good time? And here we go.
The greatest thing the devil ever did was making people believe he didn't exist.
Standing in at a height of 5 feet 9 inches, weighing in at 195 pounds. From San Francisco, California, please welcome the Devil Rebel!
Woo! And all of them boos.
Speaking of Pride Champions, Revel, our longest reigning women's Pride Champion.
Mm-hmm.
She had her sights set on the women's title. It's currently held by Strike Kira. Now she has to adapt to her new opponent.
Yes! And her opponent coming to us from Monroe County at a height of 5'7", at a weight of 135 pounds, it is Guadalupe, or is it Guadalupe?
Guadalupe does not look thrilled at all.
No?
Not too thrilled at all that she's facing Revel.
I don't think anyone would be. I'm just saying.
Well, give credit to Guadalupe, able to compose herself. Given the ready. And we are underway. Guadalupe getting the shove, going off the ropes. And that drop kick. And a little bit of damage. Oh, doing some more damage. Going off the ropes again for another drop kick. Do I hear a third? Oh, but Rebel says nah.
He's like, nah, I'm just going close line.
And that's how you do a drop kick.
That's one way.
Those Rebel probably as Guadalupe sent over the ropes. Looks like Rebel lining up a shot now. Oops. Off the ropes and ooh!
And out of the ring.
Massive wheel kick.
Oh.
Do There is not much. There is actually not much padding onto these, like on these floors.
No, and that's if there's any padding at all.
There has to be a lot of damage. Oh my goodness! Yeeting Guadalupe right. Actually, not back into the ring, right into the ring side there. Ringside ramp. And poor Guadalupe absolutely cornered. Rebel dragging Guadalupe back in, right back to the ring.
Apparently he's trying to.
Oh. And another shove will absolutely do it that time.
Yep. That one definitely worked that time. Gotta aim higher.
You can just absolutely see the annoyance on Rebel's face. Looks like she's setting up for something on the top rope.
She doesn't want to wait for too long.
And that's why, as Rebel went for a corkscrew, diving corkscrew body splash, but nobody was home there.
Absolutely.
There's a chance for Guadalupe to make way. This would be the time to do it.
Yes. Well. There was a chance.
Well, she's taking it anyway, going in for that kick.
Oh.
That actually staggered Rebel, and now just holding arm and going for more kicks right to the face.
Swear to God.
Well.
My goodness. This might be a career-defining moment for Guadalupe if she keeps this up. Implant Hurricane Rana, men for the cover. One. That's only good for one. Oh my goodness.
Man. Whew. You know what? I wonder if some about those moves hurt demons as much as it does as a regular person.
Guadalupe absolutely putting it to the test with spin kick after spin kick. And we got a third. This is exactly what you have to do against someone the likes of Rebel. Just keep applying the offensive pressure.
Definitely.
Wait, did she actually say...
Uh-huh. Yeah. She definitely did.
And... as expected, nobody was home because he basically all but warned Rebel. And Rebel just replying with a roundhouse straight to the face. Right, you can't give anyone, let alone Revel, that kind of a warning.
No.
As Revel sends Guadalupe to the one of the corners. And oh, Yakuza kick.
That one hurt.
Especially that heavy duty boot.
Mm-hmm. I definitely heard the boot. I heard the boot. Crunch.
Honestly, I'm surprised Guadalupe's face isn't any more rearranged.
Well, there's time to.
Revel's definitely making the effort to try to do that, stomping the mud.
Exactly. Quantum Crunch. You know what? I'm going to borrow that.
Stare from Revel may as well be staring an aspect of death in the face. Just absolutely yeeting Guadalupe to center of the ring. And now off the ropes for a lion salt.
Come on.
Oh, do you see the look on Rebel's face? At this point, she's having fun and she's gotta wonder if she's starting to toy with Guadalupe now.
I mean, she does that with everybody.
Sending Guadalupe off the ropes to set her up for that enziguri. And massive leg drop there.
She's definitely hurting.
Asking if Guadalupe's had enough. I would not blame Guadalupe if she said yes.
I definitely wouldn't either. I don't think anybody would.
Looks like Guadalupe disagrees. Ooh!
Oh.
Absolutely kicking Guadalupe square in the chest with that shotgun dropkick.
Ooh.
And a Dragon Slayer. This might actually be it here.
Might be.
One, two, ooh, three. Valiant Army, here is your match winner by pinfall, Revel.
Yes, yes. Boo hoo. They should know better than to send a baby out against me. Now that I've dealt with that little pest, shut up! Now that I've dealt with that little pest, Who's ready for a little story time with the devil? I have a very good one to tell you. Once upon a time, there was a young girl. She was happy, brimming with righteousness and goodness and all that shit. But she also had a lot of rage lurking under the surface. Darkness, viciousness, the urge to cause pain. One night, she hunted down a gang that had proven themselves to be especially nasty. They had snuck into her mind like a disease and consumed her thoughts. She went out alone, filled with a righteous fury, got on her motorcycle, hit her face with a helmet. She found them. She beat two of them, who were on watch with her weapons, leaving them bloodied and unconscious, before she went inside their hideout and proceeded to beat her way through their ranks. She was very ruthless, leaving them broken and bleeding out until they got to the leader. And he was the worst one, wasn't he? The cause of all her troubles. She took out her hatred on the man just like she had his little minions. But this time, she didn't stop. She kept going and going and going. His face was barely recognizable. His blood coated her fists. He was barely breathing. And only then did she kick him through a wall. It was pretty clear when he landed that his spine had snapped like a twig. Was he even alive? The girl had no clue, because she fled right after as the sound of police sirens decided to start coming after her. His name is Justin Riley. Sound familiar? He had actually died from his injuries and was brought back by paramedics at the scene, but as a shell of what he was. Spine snapped in multiple places, stuck in a wheelchair, disfigured, because someone decided to give into their rage. Isn't that right, Strike Hera? Couldn't contain yourself, I know. I know who you are, what you are, and now they all do too. You weren't even a superhero when you attacked them, just a vengeful little girl. You're more of a monster than I could ever claim to be. And you've struggled really hard to keep that rage in check, haven't you? Ever since that day. But we've already seen it, haven't we? When you fought Riv at last year's heatwave, it crept out. Yet you expect these people to just keep blindly following you and thinking you're some kind of hero? I want to see you crumble. I wonder how far I'll have to push to see it happen. Maybe I need to go after your mates, or your friends, or maybe, just maybe, your beloved brother. The path to Heatwave starts now, Strike Hera, and I'm very eager to see you lash out the more I destroy your world. Let's see how well you can keep up the superhero charade now that the truth has been pulled. Bye-bye, Super Zero.
The greatest thing the devil ever did was make you people believe you didn't exist.
Kira? That wasn't true, was it? Say it ain't so, Strike Hero.
Please.
It ain't so, right? Right? Right?
Oh! I hope not. I hope not. Wow.
I think for the first time in her career, illustrious career, the silence from her seemed kind of deafening a little bit to
me. It was. I for one just hope that it isn't true, because that would be a detriment to her career and what everybody believes.
Goodness gracious.
Well.
Well, that is a lot. That is definitely a lot to digest there.
That is.
At the same time, it's definitely right. Certainly one of those moments where she wasn't. What's not like she was in the Fed when this happened?
Yeah, but it would change people's opinions, I think. And we're moving on to our next match, coming to us from somewhere over the rainbow, at a height of 5'11", at a weight of 150 pounds. Sit down, the Tar Queen, Rona Bo.
Always have to give it to Rainbow Queen, able to play her own music to the ring.
Exactly. That's one of the best intros. Coming, long time coming. What's going on, Rain?
Looks like she's accompanied by Kusanagi.
Thank you. I will definitely hold on to this and keep it from anyone else. I'm protected.
Yeah,
it's a precious.
Remember to, right. If you see someone see someone named Barbie, do not give that to them.
Of course not. I don't even care for Barbie.
Now the mystery is solved here. Standing at a height of 6'5", weighing in at 183 pounds. From Yorkshire, United Kingdom, give it up for Bridget Strickland.
And me, I'm just over here just a dancing.
Bridget Strickland, a premier technical wrestler.
Yes.
If there's anyone who can I'm already trying to put the mind game to Rainbow. It's about holding up her end of for. What does she mean, hold up her end of a bargain? We'll have to find out later as this match is underway! Trying to go in for that wrist lock action, but Rainbow able to cartwheel out of it. And now Woo! Sin kicks her way in. Whoa! Already with the mosh pit. Rainbow all business tonight.
Already putting her out.
Now a King Kong knee drop. Now going in for the cover. That's only good for one.
Ooh.
Going in for the pickup, but Bridget shoving Rainbow back and now just giving her punch after punch right to the corner.
Ooh. Come on, Rain.
Now some knee lips just trying to break up that midsection. Just slow down Rainbow's pace.
And there goes Rain.
Yeah, able to slip out of dodge. See if the Alicorn has a counterattack. Bridget off the corner. And gets in the spear. And the cover. It's only good for one. Looks like those knee lifts are holding serve. Has definitely slowed Rainbow down. Which is pretty much exactly the pace that Bridget would prefer. Slow this match down. Make this a technical affair. Now off the ropes. Going in with a leg drop of her own. Going off the ropes again. Going for another leg drop, but just missing it. It's gonna be a chance for Rainbow to get back the momentum. Building up her combo now. Got Strickland staggered. Rain goes off the ropes.
Ooh!
Ow. Massive penalty kick. Oof, meat raptor snout. Oh.
Oh. That one hurt. I actually heard it.
Ooh. And sending Bridget to another mosh pit there.
Ooh.
Now just punching Bridget straight to the corner again. Keeping her pinned to the corner. Now here comes the backfill. Vicious kicks. Ooh, that was absolute. Oh,
man. Oh.
So sexy.
And ooh, the strum slup.
Mmm.
And what's this?
That's what I'm wondering.
What DDT from Rainbow?
Oh.
Wait a minute. That Mako and Omen?
That is. What are they doing here?
Finding her way back into this.
Mm-hmm.
Hold of Rainbow's leg. Starting with an elbow drop. And now another elbow drop square on that knee. Mako.
Oh!
Not really doing anything, so just hanging out ringside.
That kind of makes me kind of nervous.
Mako trying to ask Rainbow for
a thing muzzle.
For Isabel's muzzle.
I imagine.
And with Bridget into chopping her up and now setting up for that buzzsaw tail whip. Oh! Talk about an interesting interrogation technique.
Yeah.
Bridget going for the pin, but it was only good for two.
Finished already, are you? How utterly poisonous. Please, get up.
I don't think she's not answering because whether she does or doesn't know. I think it's because she's focused on trying to get out of this abdominal stretch.
Yeah.
Variant called the chiropractor. Oh my goodness, do you hear these cracks?
It's making that my back
me,
hurt.
That makes my back hurt just hearing that. Oh.
And see, what's sad about that, I just might have to go visit one after this match.
No, just make sure it's not Bridget, because I don't think...
Yeah.
Because she says that she's a chiropractor.
No.
Credit to Rainbow, she's trying to fight her way out of it, though.
She's trying. Come on. Come on, Rainbow. And Vanity. Oh. Ow.
That was a huge punch from Rainbow just to get out of that.
Mm-hmm.
She's absolutely feeling the effects of that chiropractor. That might slow her down to a crawl right now. Bridget back up, and she is more than willing to take advantage of this.
Ooh! Ow! Ow! Oh!
A gluteus press, just applying more pressure to the back and midsection.
Oh!
As Bridget continues to taunt Rainbow.
Oh, please get up!
Considering the damage she just did, I'm not sure if Rainbow can.
Come on, Rain. Oh.
And now a Yorkshire stretch. Oh no.
Oh.
Just adding. Jeez, these cracks and crunches of the back.
No. Can't we just have, you know, a rule that just has your. That you're only allowed to do 5 back cracking moves in a match.
Now, just adding those elbows to just further torture to Rainbow into that Yorkshire stretch.
Plan on fighting back.
Nope.
Well, you're nothing special.
Looks is a low key miracle that Rainbow's just moving
it
at
is.
All with all the damage right going off the ropes.
Oh!
I think she got a shot of adrenaline with that overhead combo sending. And Bridget crashing right into both Mako and Omen!
Yeah!
Talk about being in the wrong place at the wrong time for those two.
I mean, hey, that's on them for hanging out over there. That's on them.
This is giving Rainbow valuable time to recover.
Oh.
Wait a minute.
What's going on?
Omen and Mako making their way to the ring. Sora and Brickhouse quick to defend.
Well, this definitely just got more interesting.
And now Omen and Brickhouse going at it. Meanwhile, Sora and Mako going at it as well. Punch after punch from Omen and Brickhouse. Meanwhile, Mako got Sora in a wrist lock. Omen. Body punch after body punch, but Brickhouse responds with a jawbreaker.
Oh!
It is absolute chaos happening in the ring. Meanwhile, Omen with a massive big
DDT.
And Mako taking down Sora.
But you know, this is given both. It's pretty much giving Rain and Bridget a little bit of a break.
Ooh. Absolutely. Brickhouse and Sora trying to do everything they can to keep Mako and Omen from getting to Rainbow. And it looks like they did just that.
Yep.
Didn't think I'd hear that as an insult, but okay then. Okay then, go do you.
I mean, hey, there's all kinds of things we hear. That there doesn't surprise me.
Mako and Omen retreat. Bridget making her way back in the ring, only be the recipient of a toe kick. Basically a hoof kick, considering.
I know, right? That's just a hoof, not a foot.
But still, that's... That's even worse to the, take to the gut.
It is.
And it looks like Rainbow's getting ready to crank it up.
Come on, but Rain.
But can't she do it with her back as is?
We will find out in a moment.
She might have to settle with something else, but oh! Somehow gets the first move, and there it is! The crank it up! Oh, but she can't hold... Oh, no.
Oh!
The damage might already be done because she couldn't even get the cover.
No. And they're just both down.
Right. Bridget taking the crank it up, but at what cost to Rainbow? Is Bridget very close to the ropes? Trying to use the ropes to get herself up. Rainbow not even able to stand. This could be Bridget's chance. Going in for the waist lock. Shoving away. What a Pele kick.
That was a good kick.
And the hoof just meeting square on Bridget's forehead. Like, I'm still not sure how Rainbow's even able to do this. Oh!
I don't either.
Nephetamine! This could be it. 1, 2, 3!
Woo!
Rainbow is your winner of tonight's match by pinfall! My goodness, despite everything Bridget did to her back.
I mean,
what an effort by Rainbow.
That was a really good effort. Awesome job, Rainbow.
Also, give credit where it's due to Brickhouse Sora preventing any further chaos that could have happened when Mako and Omen.
Definitely.
Thank you for winning. Definitely good to have my friends that have your back.
It definitely is. I am just gonna hide it away. Security around it. 24/7. Protect it. Woo! That match.
Absolutely insane, and we still got more action for you tonight.
Yes, we do.
And once again, we'd like to thank Ink Oasis Lounge for giving us this beautiful Resurgence Coliseum. Mm-hmm. And be sure to check them out, as they're going to have an awesome some after party right for you. On show's end.
And we're going on to our next match. All right, our next match coming to us from Elko, Nevada, at a height of 7 foot, at a weight of 300 pounds, it is Rhea. That is one terrifying velociraptor.
Absolutely.
All right, definitely wouldn't want to meet her anywhere out in public.
Absolutely. I'm still trying to figure out how they grow them out there in Elko.
I know. Is it the genetic modification?
That's probably a mystery for another day.
Yeah. It definitely is.
Oh.
Ooh.
Hey, look, Riff, there's Johnny over there.
Come on, Johnny. That would be funny. And that would be a good match.
And introducing her opponent. Standing at a height of 6'7", weighing in at 260 pounds, from a classified location within Tokyo, Japan, please welcome Sora Kusanagi!
Money make the world go round, money make this flow so dumb, goddamn, your monopoly, my brain must be
gone. You can't say that Sora's got a little bit of momentum on her side, watching her buddy in Rainbow get for the win just earlier tonight.
True. True, true. This is going to be an interesting matchup, definitely. We've got a velociraptor and a android.
Yeah, let's hope that android's got more energy in the tank.
Probably not. I'm just saying.
Riv already going into work. Going with that arm drag. The credit to Sora, able to fight out of it. Riv just shoving her down. Back up Sora goes, but gets sent to the corner. And trying to make her way, but no. Gets only a face full of turnbuckle there. A chance for Sora to counterattack. Looks like he's about to go coast to coast for it. And what a huge Yakuza kick.
Oh.
Absolutely has ribs staggered.
She does. Oh.
Huh? Sora shoving Riv right back into that corner. Looks like Sora doing a good job carrying the momentum of saving Rainbow into this match.
Punchy,
going
punchy.
In for those punch after punch in the corner. Rune backs off as the ref, as instructed by the ref. Looks like she's got another coast to coast plan.
Mm-hmm.
Makes her way.
Oh!
Just when she thought was safe to go in for that strike, Riv going in with that lariat, and now just sending her some. Now just sending some pain back Sora's way with those elbows. Going in for a pickup. Pushing Sora away from the corner. And now, oof! His knees going straight to Sora's face. And that, and then finishing off with the elbow.
That one hurt.
Absolutely. That probably crashed some of those circuit boards, but only enough for a one. Riv lining up her shot now. Telling Sora to get up. And there she goes, but no!
Ooh!
Said the android saw it coming. And super kick right to the raptor's snout. Just like that, momentum grinds to a halt. Going in for punches, but Riv responds with a kick. Trying to set her up. I'm going for a powerbomb, but wait! Sora able to hurricane run her way out of it!
Looked like that one hurt her.
Going in for a cover, but once again, only good for one. Definitely not too often you see Riv flat on her back, yet here we are, folks.
That definitely doesn't happen often.
Sora grabbing a hold of the leg and just getting an elbow drop right on the knee.
That actually made my knee hurt. I've already got enough knee problem.
Still not a bad strategy considering rib size. If you take out one of those legs, it'll be very difficult to for her to dish out her vicious offense.
I mean, it's definitely going to bring her down a peg.
Oh, lifting up in a single leg Boston Crab.
How is that even possible?
And the android showing off her strength, locking that in. Riv saying she's not going to tap, trying to claw her way to the ropes.
Mm-hmm. She gonna grab it? Let's see.
Actually, I think she's got it.
Yeah. Yeah.
I think she hooked it with her tail.
She probably did. That is.
I mean, there is a reason why Velociraptors have a tail. That's one of them.
What clever body awareness from Rivd using her tail to grab the ropes there.
It's very smart.
Quick to recover and locking up with Sora. And ooh! That lariat was especially fiery. Going in, picking up Sora.
Mm-hmm.
Lifting her up now, and Exiaplex.
Oh.
And only good for two. That's the thing about Riv. She only needs a few moves, and you're basically already going to be in danger of a three count.
Yep.
It's like Riv once again lining up her shot. Going in. Oh, but Sora sees it coming and sets up a diamond cutter right out of nowhere. Be a chance to steal a huge win, but only good for two.
Oh.
Meanwhile, Johnny out in the crowd taking notes.
Mm-hmm. I was wondering what he was doing over there. Oh. What's,
Meanwhile, what? Sora going upstairs.
What's going on over there?
Wait a minute.
What
are you doing?
Of course he's doing what he's not supposed to be doing.
Johnny going in and attacking Sora. So that basically gives Riv a DQ.
Well.
Johnny, that...
That is one animal that needs to be put down.
Definitely... Peaky one. And Johnny just going at it now. Brawling it out. It's like Johnny's losing ground.
I mean, they're definitely going at it. Going at it hard. Oh.
Riv saying that's enough with that toe kick. Charging in, going in for a clothesline, but missed.
Oh. And out the ring they go.
And now Johnny goes.
Yep. Up.
If Riv takes this over the barricade, and looks like she is.
Up.
Give them room, please. Please, crowd, give our. Give Riv room. Do not interfere.
Yes. do not interfere. You only end up doing that once.
The last thing we need is you taking a toe claw to the face.
No, thank you. I will not. I refuse.
You have to see how crazy the action would be outside, but...
But we got other matters.
It's a win for Sora, although probably not the way she planned it.
Probably not, but hey, it definitely worked out.
Money make the world go round. Money make this flow so
I'm sure she'll probably want to get brain must be blown out wild.
I guess we just blown feels out. Damn, it's one up for nigga. Money make the world get down. We gotta get the word out now. We
knowing Sora, this is definitely not like this.
No. It has definitely been a very interesting night so far.
Absolutely. We are primed for our... We are primed and ready for what's going to be an intense main event.
Yes, sir. Who's ready? Ah, come on. But y'all can make a little more noise than that.
Yeah, I think y'all could do better.
Uh-huh.
Crowd.
Now then, that's what I'm talking about. And of course, the goat. We got the goats. I always gotta have the goat.
Absolutely.
And it looks like it's main event time.
Indeed it is.
Oh! And for our main event, coming out now from Yonkers, New York, at a height of 6'6", at a weight of 245 pounds, it is the Big Cheese, Calvin Kaso. Cheese would be good right about now.
The Bing Bong aficionado himself. This will be a massive opportunity for the Big Cheese, Calvin Kaso.
Mm-hmm.
As introducing his opponent, standing at a height of 6'6", weighing at 235 pounds. From Los Angeles, California, he's your reigning and defending valiant world heavyweight champion, Rick Bledsoe.
Well, can we just go boo? Is it allowed on comps just to say boo?
Grab his dick and twist it. Remember Rick. recently dishing out a lot of punishment to Kazim. Sure that he that the hammer will not be a part of any shenanigans against Rick. There are no distractions as we are underway for the Valiant World Heavyweight Championship. Champion applying a wrist lock. Challenger answering back with one of his own, though. Champ countering with a hammer lock, though. Credit to the challenger for answering back and reversing it. Again, the technical prowess of the champion just too much. That's sending him for the arm drag, but credit to Queso fighting his way out of it. Ooh, massive kick to the gut there. Now got that goat in the headlock.
Come on, Queso.
And now another headlock. Rick managing to take down Calvin again. And now just locking up that knuckle. And what a display of strength from Rick there. Again, that is 245 pounds of New York rat. He just belly to belly.
That hurts.
Crowd not happy with it or otherwise. That's still an impressive display from our champion. Then the kick right to Queso's gut. Those moves can be very, very painful to take, but oh, Calvin responds going off the ropes with that shoulder block.
Pardon me, just as a reminder, not unless Twitcher on comms or on the production team, please mute your mic. Thank you.
Meanwhile, champion and challenger going back and forth with these punches. Champion losing ground and getting sent to the corner with that chop. Jeez, you could have heard that from across town.
Yes.
And ooh! Roundhouse kick absolutely knocking Rick flat. I'm going for a pickup and now chop after chop. Just absolutely lighting up that chest. Ooh!
Oh! Oh!
Okay,
ow.
You could have hurt that one from across country.
I mean, or even across, you know, the globe. And he's dragging them into the middle.
So going in for the cover, trying to be a new champ, but only good for a one. And wow, great display of athleticism from Queso with that lion salt. The cover only good for a two count, though. And again, this is what you have to. Oh, wait, and just when he thought he was going to apply some more pressure. Rick hitting Calvin square on the throat. Oh. now taking down Calvin and just ramming those elbows right into Queso's face.
Ooh.
Stomping those hooves just to flatten out the big cheese. Now, Rick just going in with those knees. Sometimes taking those knees are even worse than taking those hooves. And, ooh, a corkscrew hip breaker. Going in for the cover. Rick just doing everything he can to just break Queso down piece by piece. Going in for the pickup and Wilson in for a headbutt. Not sure if that was the best idea.
Probably not. Gotta have a pretty hard head to do that.
Now just a series of kicks. Backing up Queso straight to the corner. Now just keeping those kicks going and doing it again.
Oh.
And ooh,
oh.
Magnum.
That would definitely hurt. That would definitely hurt.
Definitely as loud as Calvin's chop earlier. Probably even louder. Oh, Rick just working Calvin over that face lock. Just showing off his strength, just dragging Queso around. Now throwing him to the ropes.
Oh!
And right into the arms.
And
shows him that's how you headbutt. Horns and all. One, two. And I am surprised that Calvin's not unconscious after that.
Are we positive that he is it? Because he's not up.
Well, Rick's definitely not one to take advantage of Calvin in this prone position. Just working over the leg. The kicks and knees going straight to the thigh.
He just keeps going.
Well, this is the standard MO of the champ's game plan. You always make sure you're completely broken down before he pins you. And oh! That knee using the ropes to leverage right into Calvin's face. And now another belly-to-belly suplex. Again, the impressive strength yeeting Calvin all the way to beyond center of the ring.
Ooh.
Going in for the cover, but only good for two. You have to give credit to Calvin. He knows what's at stake here.
He definitely does. Where's he going?
Yeah, I can't say I blame him too much. He's just needs that little bit of respite. Trying to create some distance from the champ.
Mm-hmm. Oh!
But he had a chance to do it. No. Chance to make the comeback, but no. Rick taking him down and just wailing on Calvin now.
Ow.
And now more stomps. Again, the ruthlessness from Rick, absolutely textbook right now. Oh, climbing up the apron. And nails the diving headbutt.
What? And
was square on Calvin's midsection there.
And we've got the count up to 5.
And knowing Rick, I'm sure he wouldn't mind taking this all the way to 10. Because champion's advantage. Whoa! Calvin absolutely crashing into the barricades. That messed up with one of our ad screens.
Ah, why? Don't they know that's bad luck? And how much that costs?
Oh boy.
Come on, Calvin. Get back up there.
And look at this.
And the count's up to 4.
Rick just kicking back and...
Mm-hmm.
Calvin can even make the effort. As Calvin crawling his way. Made his way to the apron.
We're up to 7. Come on. 8. Come on, Calvin. 9. And he gets back in.
Makes his way back to the ring.
On that very last number, too.
But this, right. And all that does is piss Rick off and...
and...
tried to go in, but Calvin, back body drop. Good on Calvin just to keep making that distance. Somehow rolls out under that clothesline and a leg lariat.
Woo!
Calvin lining up his shot, gets in another leg lariat. Rick tries to go for a clothesline, but Calvin not only dodges it, what a Pele kick. Again, only here at Valiant Wrestling can you see tremendous athletes like these go at it.
Mm-hmm. Ooh!
Protect your neck! didn't even give the champ a chance to get back up. Oh, and just when we thought we had a new champion, and Rick kicks out at two. Calvin, naturally frustrated, slapping the mat. Really wanted that to be that third slap to be from the ref.
I mean, that's all of us. Oh!
Looks like he's paying that ruthlessness back in kind with that knee slam. Calvin going upstairs. What you got planned?
There's no talent. Oh!
The bubonic bomb! Going in for a cover. One, two, out!
We were just that close from a brand new world heavyweight champion.
No, but this is especially not good. Calvin looks like he's out of gas. Even questioning what he has to do to bring the champ down.
Personally, I would recommend to pull a move just like the current champion does at the very end.
Oh, wait, we gotta roll! We gotta roll up! Mm-hmm. One, two, no!
Oh, that was so close!
Rig almost stealing victory out of the jaws of defeat there with that roll up.
Oh!
Now just stomping. Been Calvin flat there. Just an absolute frustration. Got him up and whoa! Giant swing! How many times can he hold it? No, he's going faster with it! And whoa!
Whew. Round and round they go.
And yeah, not surprising. Rick is kind of dizzy from that.
Yeah, I mean, I would be too.
Or is he? Somehow. Somehow locks up Calvin in a paradise lock.
Okay, that's interesting.
Wait a minute, no. He's not going to do what I think he's going to do.
I think he is. And that's even a low blow from someone who does it.
No!
Oh! Oh!
My goodness! Calvin was about as defenseless as you can ever be! Locked up in that paradise lock as he took that stop. One, two, three.
Oh.
Calvin tried his best, but Valiant Army, your winner and still champion, Rick Bloodrose.
Meh. Nah. He is not my champion. I'm not gonna claim him. Nope.
Almost 8.
And I will drag you
Yeah. Cannot take credit away from Calvin Kasa, though. A tremendous effort, but again, the champ showing why he's the champ. As he can give it just as well as he can give it. So.
I mean, hey, at least there wasn't anything surprising out of him. But you know, the way of a chair or a table.
Yeah, absolutely, but still, his ruthlessness is definitely unquestioned here.
Mm-hmm.
And somebody stop his championship reign. We'll have to figure out at another time.
Yep. And just as a reminder, once again, there is going to be a awesome after party at the Oasis Lounge. Everybody is welcome to come. And I've actually got the link right here. That's the teleport for it after we're done here and after the meet and greet.
And that will just about do it.
It has been a very busy, very busy one tonight.
Absolutely. Tremendous show all around. Thrills, chills, and spills.
I don't think we have anything else.
That will do it, folks.
Yes.
Be sure to tune in next week. Same time, 6 o'clock SLT for another rousing edition of Valiant Flashpoint.